There is a deeper personality in him which did the actions. So the outer actions are only reflections of this person. He was a politician who used the spiritual power to liberate him. Not anything else. Of course, Sri Aurobindo was very practical. Let's not say only did meditation. All those movements of Satyagraha, boycott and all that that Netaji did and Gandhiji did later on were all initiated by him. Politicians have a very short aim that I want freedom of the country, I want this law to be enacted. But here was a person who gave an ideal to freedom. That is the genius of the man.
I see this idea running through the movie that this is not just about British and India's freedom struggle. It's about freedom from ignorance. Even when he's fighting the British, what is his state? There is a poem, One Self, where he says, it ends with two lines, my enemy's downfall is my own disgrace. I look at my enemy and see Krishna's face. He looked at it all as part of a large plan, why they came and what was the purpose. It will not be the rancor, hatred, or with aggression, violence. So he was not in favor of that kind of non-violence as a state policy. Certainly not. He said non-violence can be practiced by an individual, that's fine. But if you make non-violence a state policy, say Hitler wants to walk into your house and you say, I will not lift a lathi, that is depriving man of his manhood. So these are some of his key ideas. They can be brought into the film. I mean, I conceive it like that.
Without the knowledge, the power, the ancient truth that India has found, if this goes dry, if this becomes a Europeanized country, then the world is at risk of its future. So Sri Aurobindo wanted India to become free so that it can become its own back to itself. It recovers itself, which is the panacea for the future world, which is the survival point for the future of the world. So you are dealing with a rishi, with a spiritual person. Unless and until you invoke him, all your best presentation you might have done with anything. And your film should attract and impact that higher range. Even if you get 500 people or 1,000 people out of your film, turn to a deeper, I will not even call spirituality. Turn to a deeper quest. That's it.
In India, people are still very much related to live action storytelling. In the West, they have seen the potential of animated storytelling and they love it. And it's not restricted to children. And it's not restricted to cartoon. These two boxing that happens with animation, oh, you're making a cartoon out of him, or it must be for children.
Yeah.
These two, you know, premeditated biases that people have for animation is changing, but it's changing slowly with exposure. To keep Sri Aurobindo's or any such character personalities, to embody them into a character in a film, it's always better that we take support of art. Because art can speak beyond what can be spoken with flesh and blood.
For a lot of questions that we are asking the sadhaks here, like they sometimes prefer to just answer using a line from one of the poems. So we realize that there is it is actually so powerful and so meaningful for them. It sort of guides them every day. So we are even contemplating, like, would this be like a more powerful way of, you know, speaking about his philosophy in the film, rather than just, you know, do a chronological sequence.
Poet that he was, I mean, his work of art, his teachings are through poetry, and it is resonating so much, and it's only growing, right? How would you document a poet's life? I mean, you can talk about his events in his life to whatever degree of accuracy you may know, but is that accurate? We would come to know about this person to connect the people who have no idea about him. We need to bring that essence of him, and that is what people would connect with. And for that, I feel there has to be an art form that needs to. It is not a regular cinema. It's not a documentary for sure. Documentary is the easiest way out. But it needs to be a visual poetry. A poet's life through words. We need to kind of narrate it through a visual poetry. And I think that was his life. It was more of a poem that has so much spiritual and emotional, I would not say residue, but it has so much impact on people, which is growing day by day. It cannot be a regular entertainment feature film. Yeah. The purpose of it is not entertainment.
Yeah.
The purpose of it is not giving information. The purpose of it is, along with information and the story, to create a connect at an emotional level,
at
a soulful
level,
and you know where it needs to connect with you at various levels. So what is that particular medium? What is that experience that we want to give our audience through this film? It is something that we need to really evolve and design very carefully.
You are aspiring to touch the soul of people, and especially the soul of this nation. This great spiritual nation of India.
Yeah.
I would think that if the film can do beyond the borders of India,
I think
that
can.
Would be the right justice for what Sri Aurobindo also visualized, what India can play a role around the world, you know.
People are seeking all over the world.
And one of the very powerful things that we've felt from all the people who we've been speaking with is that his words stand up for a lot of meaning to them in actually making them lead their lives on a daily basis. His words have that much importance in their life. It's almost like the steering wheel in their lives. So we felt that, you know, something that we didn't consider earlier, what if his words can be there in this film?
Yeah.
So where do you go from here now on the project? Where are you at and where are you leading in the next, let's say, month or two?
In the next month or two before 2022, we have to have the structure in place, the story structure in place. So we will be writing, we will be reimagining our, various learnings that we got from this experience. We will be visualizing them. There will be a visual script that we would like to do. Not just the written script, but a visual script is something that we would like to develop. Mm.
Mm.